Hello, John Talley here with PartZilla.com. Today we're going to be looking at the charging system on our 2015 Polaris RZR 900S. Nothing's more frustrating to be out there on the trail and then you lose all power to the system. Well, there's a few simple things we can look at to figure out what's going on. So let me go grab a couple of tools and we'll start to dig into it. All right, guys, this is going to be a skill level one, and don't go into convulsions just because you see a volt ohm meter. All right, the tools that you're going to need to do this. Well, like I just pointed out, a volt ohm meter, just make sure it has the ability to test diodes. Other than that, a 3/8 ratchet, and then a 10 millimeter on an extension. That's all the tools you're going to need to pull this off. All right, as far as the parts go, well, that's to be determined, but if you would reference our parts diagrams, that'll show you the things that we're going to look at today, and that's going to be the voltage regulator rectifier as well as the stator. So once you have your tools and your potentially your parts together, I can go over there and show you how to diagnose it. So let's go. All right, guys, when you're trying to tackle diagnosing a charging system issue, you want to start simple. So the first thing we want to do is lift out the seat, take a look at the battery, test it, and make sure it's in good shape. Then we can go on to the next part of the system. So let's get the seat out of the way. Let's take a look at our static voltage. That'll give us at least an indicator of if the battery's in good shape or not. So we're looking for anything over about 12 and a half volts. All right, so we're at 12.48 volts. Now what we want to do next, we're in park, is start it up and see if there is a variation from that. We should see 13 and a half, 14 volts roughly at idle. So let's see what she does. All right. See, we're down about right at 12 volts. Doesn't move. Should be coming up. So yes, this unit is having an issue. So where do we go next? Well, I'm relatively confident that there's nothing wrong with the battery, and otherwise it wouldn't have started. But it's only going to run for a limited amount of time before it depletes what charge the battery does have. So let's go take a look at our regulator rectifier and see if we've got any voltage coming from the stator itself. All right, guys, here's what we're going to be testing first. This is the stator, and it's actually inside the engine on the other side. And what this is basically a device that creates AC voltage, virtue of magnets going around these coils. And it actually plugs into the regulator rectifier down here. Right. In the manual, they actually say, all right, they want to do a resistance check. Well, the only resistance check I do is from each one of these phases, if you will, reference to ground. If there's a direct, if you see resistance there, this thing's shorted out to ground. They also say that you can measure resistance going from phase to phase, and that's supposed to be in between 0.07 and 0.13 ohms. I don't know about you, but I don't know of many voltmeters that can measure that accurately. So what we're gonna do is just measure it to ground to make sure this isn't grounded out, and then we're gonna switch it over to AC voltage and do a voltage measurement. On the AC side, at idle, we should be somewhere around 20 volts. As you increase the RPMs up to about 4,000 or 5,000, it'll get anywhere up to 70, 75 volts. And that'll signify a healthy stator. So let's check the resistance just going to ground. If that checks out, then we'll go ahead and measure the AC voltage. All right, I went ahead and unplugged the entire unit to where we can actually access it. All right, let's change our meter over to resistance, which is that little symbol right there, measured in ohms. And now we're measuring to ground, so we need to find a ground on the unit somewhere. And we're probably close enough to go up to the battery. So I'm gonna head up here and just attach it to the ground side. Now, I'll take my positive lead off the volt ohm meter, and we're just gonna go to each phase. We pretty much want the meter to stay just like it is. We just wanna see an open circuit. So that's what OL stands for. All right, going to the first phase, open, open, and open. So that's a good thing. That's what we really want. Now, let's get our lead back. Going to change our meter over to AC volts. And that's that symbol right there. V with a sine wave over the top of it. All right, V, AC. What we're going to do is we're going to measure phase to phase. So if you want to think of these as 1, 2, 3, we'll go 1 to 2, 1 to 3, and then 2 to 3. So I'm going to start it up. You probably won't be able to hear me. We're just going to do it at idle, so we should see around 20 volts, and we're going to go through it. And y'all just keep watching right there. Now going 1 to 3. And we're going to go 2 to 3. All right. All right, so that right there is telling me that I have an operational stator. So the next thing we need to do is take a look inside, so to speak, the regulator rectifier, because the regulator rectifier's job is to turn that AC voltage into DC. How does it do that? Well, it has a network of diodes that actually cut off the tops and the bottoms and then creates a DC signal by inverting the sine wave and with a couple of capacitors. Don't want to go into it too deep. All we really want to know is, are those diodes operating properly? So let me go grab the meter, reset it to that little symbol right there. And the diode checker is actually right there. So we're going to toggle that over. And to do this, want to make sure that the battery connection is actually hooked up, because what we're going to do is reference back to ground, and we're actually going to forward bias the diode. And when we do that, it'll show the voltage that it takes to push it forward, which is 0.5 volts. So, that being said, you take the positive side of your meter, and that needs to go to the negative on the chassis, or I'm actually going to go to the battery. So, when we go through on each phase, let me put this back up here, what you're going to see hopefully is 0.5 volts for each one, and all three of them need to be that reading. So, first one, 0.522, that's what we're looking for. Number two looks good, 0.521. Looky there. Number three, there's nothing there. So that tells me that the number three diode is actually opened up. So guess what? This thing's not charging properly, and that's the reason why. So this is where we need to replace that voltage regulator rectifier. So let me go grab one, let's pop it in place, and then remeasure it. I bet you that's gonna fix our problem. So we've got it unplugged, and it's only held in place by a couple of 10 millimeter bolts. So let's go ahead and get her out of there. All right, so we've got the old one out, got the new one to go in. Make sure you've got that little shield on the bottom of it. Let's get her bolted back up. All right, guys, hopefully you've got really long arms, because there's actually a bolt on the other side of that plastic that's loose, so to speak. So you have to reach around and actually hold it to get this mounted back up. Let's tighten them back down. All right, just for kicks, let's do our test in reverse now. Hook up the vehicle ground and the power as well to the battery. Grounding our positive lead. We're still in the diode check. Let's see what we've got. 0.51, 0.51, 0.51. So there we go. Plug our stator back into the rectifier. Make sure you hear that click. Now, let's reset this back to DC volts, connect this back up to the battery location, move the positive over where it's supposed to be, ground it, 12.43. Now let's start it up and see what it does. Now we got something. Well, all right, guys, that pretty much wraps this one up. Well, listen, if you need any of the parts that are bad on your machine, why don't you come see us at partzilla.com and we can get you taken care of. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. Till next time, we just want to say thanks for watching.